Welcome to my channel. In this video we will see about the water jug problem. What is the water jug problem? Water jug problem says that we have two jugs, X jug and Y jug. Okay, this jug is having capacity 4 gallon of water, this jug is having capacity of 3 gallon of water. Okay, mark is not mentioned in either of the jug and there is no problem of water, and we want exactly 2 gallon of water in the X jug. So how you will do? This is all about the water jug problem. So for that, different production rule will be applied here as well as state space representation will be applied here. So if you have not watched my production rule video, so go and watch that video as well as state space representation video, and then you will come here, so you will understand here. Now we will see about the different production rule as well as their pictorial representation. So you will understand each and every production rule and their representation, and then we will apply the rule so that we will solve our water jug problem. Okay. So these are the production rule that I have written for the water jug problem. As I told, X is 4 gallon of 4 gallon jug and Y is a 3 gallon jug. Okay. So I have written here production rule. Production rules are means set of rules that are defined in the artificial intelligence program. So I have written production rule and correspondingly I have shown with the diagram. So you will understand specifically and precisely what is going on in each and every production rule. So what first production rule says, X and Y, it is a state space, and in that case I have written the production rule that if X is less than 4, means if in X jug there is some water, but if the water is less than 4, it might be 0, 1, 2, 3, but it is less than 4, so we will make it fill completely, so the state space become 4Y. That I have shown with this diagram. Suppose this jug has having less than 4 gallon of water, so we will make it full, X equal to 4. In a similar way, if Y is having less than 3 water, so we will make it fill completely. That I have shown in this diagram. Y is less than 3 and we will make it fill completely. So Y has become 3 because the maximum capacity of Y jug is 3. In a similar way, if X is in third rule, if X is having water more than 0 and we want to take it out some D amount of water, so what we will do? We will write here X minus D, where is the D is the amount that we want to take it out from there. So we will write here X minus D comma Y, that I have shown in this diagram. This is the jug X is having a more of water than 0 and if we want to take it out the amount of water, so we will write here X minus D. So this the amount of water will be taken from here. In a similar way, Y is having more water than 0 and if we want to take out the amount of water, so we will write here X comma Y minus D. D is the amount of water that we want to take it out from the Y jug. Okay, so that I have shown in this diagram. Y jug is shown in the blue and black color of jug is of X jug. Okay, so this D amount of water we want to take it out from here, so we will write here. So this is D amount of water from the Y which is having more than 0 water. So D amount after taking this D amount of water, remaining state will be Y minus D. That I have shown with the production rule 4. In a similar way, if X is having more water than 0, means it is having some water and if we want to make it 0, so we will write here 0 comma Y. That I have shown in the fifth. Suppose this is a jug, it is having more than some water is there, and if you want to take it out completely, so it will become X equal to 0. So that I have written here. Okay. So 0 comma Y. In a similar way, is Y is having some water and if you want to make it completely empty, so we will write here X comma 0. So that I have shown with this diagram. Suppose this is jug having a more than some water in it and if you want to completely out, so Y becomes a 0. Okay. So 7. Seventh rule says if X and Y both together having amount of water which is equal to 4 or greater than 4, and at the same time why is having some water, which condition it is, seventh condition, this is the. Suppose X is having water, Y is having water, they are together is more than 4. And if we want to make pour water from the 3-gallon jug into the 4-gallon jug, until the 4-gallon jug, and then we want to take some water from the Y-gallon jug and fill completely X-gallon jug. So that I have shown with this diagram. Suppose it is having X, it is having Y, Y jug is having more than 0 water, and we want to make fill completely X jug. So we will become X equal to 4. So the amount that we have taken from the Y into X will be shown as Y minus 4 minus X. So that I have shown with this diagram. So X will become the full, and the amount that is taken from the Y will be decreased. So that I will be shown Y minus 4 minus X. Okay, in a 8th rule, suppose X and Y jug both together having it more than or equal to 3 gallon of water, and X is having some water, which is shown in the diagram 8. X is having some water and both together is having more or equal to water 3, and we want to take out some water from Y to X. That means X to Y, that we want to take out water from X to Y, that means we want to make the Y gallon fill completely. So we will write here Y minus 3, and the amount that is taken from X to Y will be written as X minus 3 in bracket 3 minus Y. So that is I have shown in this rule, that we want to make the Y jug completely, so we have written X minus 3 minus Y comma 3. Okay, so this is the both the rules, 7th and 8th is coming together. We made fill completely X jug with the 4 gallon, and in 8th rule we make the jug Y completely fill. Okay, now what 9th rule says? 9th rule says that X jug and Y jug both is having amount is water which is less than equal to 4 gallon. So what, and second condition is that Y jug is having some amount of water. So what we will do, we will take out all the water from Y and make and pour into the X jug. So we have written X plus Y, and Y jug becomes a 0. That I have shown in the 9. Suppose this is the X is having some water, Y is having some water. So what we have done, we have taken this Y amount of water into the X. So X jug will fill as much as possible. It might be full or it might be some less, and Y becomes a 0. In a similar same case happened with the 10th rule, in which is X and Y both together is having less than or equal to 3 gallon of water, and X is having 0 amount of water. So what we will do, we will make X jug 0, and we will take all water from X to the Y. So that I have shown in the 10th rule here. Suppose X having some amount of water and Y is having some amount of water, but both together is water amount is less than or equal to 3. So I have taken all the water from X and as much as possible and shift into the transferred into the Y jug. Okay. 11th rule says, whatever, suppose X is having 0 amount of water and Y is having 2 gallon of water. So we will take out all water from Y and transfer into the X. So the status will become 2, 0. That I have shown in this. X is having nothing is there in X, and Y is having 2 gallon of water. So we will transfer all the water from Y to X. So X becomes the 2 gallon of water and Y becomes the 0. In a last condition, it is shown that 2, y. That means X is having 2 gallon of water, and Y we are not telling about Y jug. So X just becomes the 0. We are not touching Y. So that is shown in the 12th rule, that X is having 2 gallon of water and Y. So we will take it up out, fill, take it out on the ground. So X becomes a 0 and we are not concerning about the Y jug. So Y remains as it is. So I have shown you the production rule and their pictorial representation. Now my objective is here that you will understand this production rule clearly, so that we will apply while we solve the water jug problem. Okay. So now I am rubbing it and then we will apply the rule that will solve our water jug problem. Okay, initially both the jug is having zero amount of water. So which will rule we will apply? We will apply rule number second. Okay, so by that rule y jug will be filled completely, then it becomes 3 and we have not touched with the anything with the x jug. Now we want to take all the water from y jug into the x jug, so we will apply rule number 9. So we will write here rule number 9. So this become 0, this become 3 and this become 0. Now once again we want to fill it completely, so we will apply rule number second. So once again it will come, then what it will become? 3 and 3. Okay, now what we want? We want this 1 gallon of water that shift from Y jug to the X jug. So what we will write? We will write here rule number 7. Okay, so here it will come rule number 7. By that it becomes 4 and it becomes 2. Okay, now we want to take all the water from the X jug. So with what rule we will apply? We will apply rule number 5, because by this X jug becomes the empty. So we will apply rule number 5. So this will become 0 and this will become 2. Now we want to apply once again rule number 9, so that this amount of water will be transferred from Y jug to the X jug. So we will apply rule number 9 once again. Okay, so this become 2 and this become 0. So that we wanted, that X jug is having 2 gallon of water. Okay. I hope you understood the concept of water jug problem as well as the different production rules, their pictorial representation and how you will apply the rule for solving the water jug problem. So please like and share my video, and watching more videos like this, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.